Hello friends, today I am going to share my experience in the university system, because I worked for a long time in the university for 32 years, and even prior to that I had been lecturer at the college level. So it is my great privilege to share my experience with you about the university structure and system. The first question arises when I am talking about university structure and system. First question arises in my mind is, what is university? And another question, what is the purpose of establishing the university? The answer for this question is given in a quote given by first Prime Minister of India, Dr. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, where he says, university stands for humanism, tolerance, for reason, for adventure of ideas, and for the search of truth. It stands for the forward march of the human, of the truth. The quote given by Jawaharlal Nehru itself is a self-explanatory. What is university? As per him, the university stands for humanism and tolerance, for reason, for adventure of ideas, for the search of truth. It stands for forward the march of the human race towards even higher education. If the university discharge their duties adequately, then it is well with the nation and for the people. So it simply means higher universities are established for development of nation, to fulfill the needs of the society, and to take a nation long ahead with the changing speed of the world. And then if we want to go with the world, we have to establish the universities. And how to establish the university is itself is given in the UGC Act. As per UGC Act, it is mentioned that university means a university established or incorporated by or under Central Act or Provincial Act or State Act, and includes any such institution as may in consultation with the University Grants Commission. It is to be recognized by the UGC, that is called as the university as per UGC Act. When universities are established in the India, it means that university has to be sanctioned the permission from the University Grants Commission. Kind of university or types of universities in India are Central University, State University, Deemed University, and now private universities. These are the different types of universities, but they are listed and given a permission by UGC itself. Now, university is there, they are functioning. For their functioning, there should be a structure or there should be a system. If we talk about the structure, structure means, if we go roughly, the structure can be a, suppose we take an example of sentence, then grammatical structure of sentence. Or if we took an example of any building, the infrastructure, the columns, beams is a structure of that building. Accordingly, university should have some structure, and that structure is to be followed with the system. So, structure means the structure of the university, that means there are different departments in the university. That departments functions together as per system given by the university. System means, again, what is system? If we go to the definition of the system, the manner in which institution or aspect of the society are arranged is called as a system. For example, in a university like Pune University, which is an affiliating university, the institution which want to establish the college is one institute, then college itself is another institute, and university is a third institute. They come together and functions together, that is the university system. And this kind of functioning is defined in the, or is prepared by the university itself. So, there is a structure, there is a system, university is there. Now, purpose of university, to fulfill the need of society is in all perspective through higher education and research. Universities are required to make different programs, courses, has to update curriculums time to time. As I said earlier, the universities are meant for the fulfilling the need of the society to cope up with the speed of the international or national level. For example, computerization or use of IT is a new area which is emerged in last few years. Prior to that, traditional education like BA, BCom, BSc was there. Our curriculums were like that. I remember when I was pursuing my first degree, that is BSc. At that time, BSc computer science program was not there. But then in 1984, 85, 86, the BSc computer science program is started by Pune University. This kind of changes to cope up with the speed of change in the world. After that, biotechnology is emerged, IT is emerged. These changes, this need of the society has to be identified by the university, identified by the university, and therefore, to fulfill the need of the society means to start the courses which will not only give the employment to the youth, but also to give support to the industry, support to that emerging area. For example, even in last year, Pune University has started BSc Civil Aviation as a new course. This is also only because this is consistent with the changing era. Civil aviation in India, before last 5 to 10 years, it was very small industry, and now number of aeroplanes are started. Even now, just within next few days, Nasik to Pune aeroplanes are going to start. Planes will come from Nasik to Pune. That means civil aviation is increasing, so need in that area will also increase, and so such a changes are to be taken care by the university is one of the thing for changing the curriculum. Not only new courses, but again in the present courses also curriculum has to be updated, and that has to be according to change in the society. For example, I pursued BSc computer science, BSc statistics, then MSc statistics. At that time, computer subjects or computer related subjects were not there in the curriculum, but now as it is required in the curriculum, such a changes came, and such a changes are to be done by the universities. Not only making the curriculum or starting the new courses is the functioning of the university, but then suppose one good program is started, then to run that program, we need good college, good teachers, and to supervise that things, universities control should be there. And that is why one of the statement I can make, that to administrator, supervise or control the academic and administrative governance of execution of course is one of the function of the university. To evaluate the knowledge gained by student through that course, the examination system is required. To prepare the course, start the curriculum, give the knowledge to the students, and to evaluate to the students is main function in the university system.